Let's take a look at this next request. So the next one is a Pulp song, and this one is called Disco 2000. So taking it back a second, I think, you know, to my knowledge, the only song I've heard from Pulp was Common People, which is a fantastic song. And again, it's probably become one of my most viewed songs on the channel and most commented songs. I get so many people in comments telling me that one, that the song is fantastic and they really enjoy the song, and then two, I get a lot of people telling me they enjoyed my reaction to the song, which I really appreciate as well, and that I kind of really understood the lyrics and the sort of message behind the song. So I really appreciate those comments from you guys, and so I'm actually really excited to get back to this band because I did like Common People so much. So I say we go ahead and jump into it. Again, this is Pulp, Disco 2000. Here we go. Wait, before we do that, let me grab the lyrics, and then here we go. All right, lyrics are here. Let's do it. A little different. I like that a whole lot. I like that a whole lot. That was a good song. I'm gonna pause that real quick. I completely agree with everybody in the chat right now. I think Linda and Ursha, saying that this is very much like one of those like coming of age, like 1980s coming of age movie like soundtrack type songs. But it looks like here it was released October 30th, 1995. So just really cool sounding, very fun. Again, very gives you that sort of coming of age feeling. I don't know what gives certain songs. Maybe it's just the age that we've reached, right? I'm curious as to, you know, what Gen Z's coming of age songs will be. But I guess for us who grew up in, you know, the 80s, 90s, or even maybe early 2000s, like this sort of coming of age sound and what it means to us. And that's the best way I can really describe it, is that coming of age sound. But I liked it a whole lot, and it is kind of funny. I think it was Inertia who mentioned it. The mention of the year 2000, right? Because that, like, now that's like 22 years ago, which is really wild to believe. But it's just like, yeah, but then it's like, well, let's meet up in 5 years, right? It's like if someone said, hey, let's meet up in 2027, it's just like, ouch, ooh, it doesn't have the same ring to it. But anyway, let's take a look at the song. Let's break it down piece by piece. Let's start with those lyrics, of course, but first, this about section. One of the band's most famous songs off their seminal 1995 album Disco 2000 is a Britpop classic, which sees singer Jarvis Cocker lament over his childhood sweetheart and imagines where and who she is now. All right, taking a look at the lyrics here. So, we were born within 1 hour of each other. Our mother said we could be sister and brother. Your name is Deborah. Deborah, it never suited ya. And they said that when we grew up, we'd get married and never split up. Oh, we never did it, although I often thought of it. So, yeah, you know, people who grew up, kind of grew up near each other, grew up, I guess it's sort of the same circumstances in the same circles. And I'm sure these stories have been told all the time, right? Where you grow up with like your childhood friend. It's like, oh, these two will get married eventually, right? And then just, it never worked out for them. So, oh, Deborah, do you recall your house was very small, with wood chip on the wall. When I came round to call, you didn't notice me at all. And I said, let's all meet up in the year 2000. Won't it be strange when we're all fully grown? Be there 2 o'clock by the fountain down the road. I never knew that you'd get married. I would be living down here on my own. Oh, on that damp and lonely Thursday years ago. So it's kind of that coming of age sound, but it's also sort of just like, yeah, you know, like everybody said we get married. And so when I tried to, you know, to come around courting, it was just, you were just like not into it. So I was like, well, you know, why don't we wait a few years and feel it out? And of course she goes off and gets married, dude's all by himself. And now she's kind of like, damn, I had no idea that would be our fate. The fountain by the road is the main fountain complex in Sheffield, England, apparently hometown of Pulp. The location is known to every Sheffield citizen and is considered a go-to location for most meetings. The time, however, is a bit specific. It might indicate the fact that he wants to get to know her before the new millennium begins, as 10 hours is plenty of time. Interesting. Okay, so the fountain here is pretty popular, I guess. Interesting. This is based off a real person, apparently. Deborah married a man called Colin Bone, but remained close friends with Cocker throughout her life. Sadly, she died in 2015, not long after Cocker sang this song for her at her 50th birthday. Oh, so it's based on a true story. That's very sweet. I would be living down here on my own on that damp and lonely Thursday years ago. You were the first girl at school to get breasts, and Martin said that you were the best. Oh, the boys all loved you, but I was a mess. I had to watch them try and get you undressed. We were friends, that was as far as it went. I went to walk you home sometimes, but it meant nothing to you because you were so popular. So, I mean, I think it's pretty self-explanatory there. Deborah, do you recall your house was very small with wood chip on the wall? When I came around to call, you didn't notice me at all. And I said, let's all meet up in the year 2000. Won't it be strange when we're all fully grown? Be there 2 o'clock by the fountain down the road. I never knew that you'd get married. I would be living down here on my own on that damp and lonely Thursday years ago. Deborah, do you recall your house is very small? Let's see, you didn't notice me at all. Let's all meet up in the year 2000. Won't it be strange when we're all fully grown? Be there by 2 o'clock. Essentially she just went on to be like the popular girl in school, and he was just kind of like some dude, you know? oh, what are you doing Sunday? But it was just kind of funny because at the end of the day, he became like this, you know, this huge pop star, I guess. And now she's, I don't know what she did with her life. She could have also been huge. I have no idea. But anyway, oh, what are you doing Sunday, baby? Would you like to come and meet me? Maybe you can even bring your baby. So, I mean, it sounds like they're still friends, right? She's married, she's got a kid, but it's like, hey, you know, let's hang out. What are you doing Sunday? Well, the fact that he calls her baby, though, is kind of weird. Would you like to come and meet me? Maybe you can even bring your baby. Okay, I mean, you know. Lyrically, again, it's sort of that sort of coming-of-age story, right? I do really love the nostalgia of saying, like, hey, let's meet up in 5 years and see how it goes, you know, that kind of thing. I think, you know, for some people, probably a pretty relatable song, right? You know, they have this crush, and crush doesn't even know they exist, and you know, that whole thing. Kind of maybe a little cliche in some ways, but, you know, I think lyrically it was still pretty solid. I give it a thumb up. As far as the instrumentation goes, I love the guitar work throughout, actually. I was, before we really got into the chorus, I was expecting this to be more like on the rock and roll side of things, because that guitar really just comes in sort of fast and furious and was really enjoyable really throughout the song. But I do like that they kind of leaned more into the pop side of things. And again, it's called Disco 2000 for a reason, because again, this released in 1995, referencing the song 2000, the year 2000, but definitely felt more like a song from, like you guys said, the 80s. Now disco was kind of out of its fad at the 80s, but still kind of had that classic sound to it, which was really nice. So I think vocally, his vocal performance here goes really well with what they were doing instrumentally and lyrically. So I think the vocal and instrumental performance here were fantastic. I give it two big thumbs up. As far as replay value goes, you know, it's kind of interesting. Because again, like if this song were written nowadays, it'd be like, hey, let's meet up in 2027. It just feels weird to me. This is sort of like it had to be done when it was done. It's like a product of its time. It just feels very fun to listen to. Has that, again, that coming of age sound, and it was just, yeah, it was a great listen. So I definitely want this one on my playlist, and I honestly can't wait to listen to it again. It's very, it's one of those songs that's kind of fun to listen to. You can sort of ignore maybe some of the problematic things in the lyrics, because it is just so fun to jam out to and listen to. Like, in the guitar, I think throughout really carries it for me. So I give it a thumb up for replay value as well. Overall, a pretty good song. So I want to thank whoever requested this one. This is good. I think Pulp so far is 2 for 2 in my opinion. So.